You are watching the NARCH live stream. Jeremy Ellis coming to you from the Hershey Center here at the 2017 NARCH Finals. It is pro action between the OC Bears and the Verbero Cypress. And this is our bow on our present that we call day one of the NARCH Finals. Jeremy Ellis will be joined momentarily by color man extraordinaire Alex Morrison, who is busy researching some of these rosters here as we speak with our crack statistical staff. Here comes Purcell right in, and Purcell had it knocked off his stick. And we are underway. 20 seconds into this one, the Bears in the sharp, we'll call these teal aquamarine uniforms with black pants. The Cypress with the white jerseys with gold trim and black pants. Here come the Cypress back the other direction. Taking a big shot and running right into the goaltender. We're going to have a penalty. It's going to be a call against the offensive player as he steamrolled into the goaltender for the Bears. Let's see who the goaltender was. Maybe Bobby Sand, number 66. But he went down hard. We've got a delayed penalty. The goaltender is on the bench, so now as soon as they cross that red line, they cannot bring the puck back the other direction. Play will go down low. And now it goes across the red line. So there's the immediate whistle. And it'll go against, I believe, number 84, who we have an outdated roster. We're going to have to get on the equipment manager of the Cypress for giving us that poor information. Good looking group over there on the OC Bears bench as they get ready to go on the power play. So the OC Bears will go on the special teams unit here first. I'll work it across the top now. With it is Russolello. Back up top now. Willie Boyle. Russolello trying to track it down. He battles for it in the corner. Bodies come together, and it's finally tracked back now by the Bears, Connor Cafferty. Down low to Russolello. Back up top, gets a return pass. Couldn't handle it. Tried to swing it down low. Russolello has it back up top. Over to the corner, tried to go back door, shot right out in front. Goaltender scrambling all over the place, broken twig on the floor. Puck goes out of play as bodies come together. So with the puck out of play, stoppage here, 12:41 left here in the first period, 32 seconds left in the man advantage. Big goal mouth scramble there. Great camera work by Parker Moskal up there in the camera booth. Like to call him the Moskal Mule. Puck taken back there by the Bears. Here they come the other direction now. Only 15 seconds remaining on the man advantage. After that last stoppage, faking a shot was O'Shaughnessy. O'Shaughnessy retreats back almost to the red line. Only 5 seconds remaining in the penalty. There's a big shot off the stick of Sosa. Track back down now and taken by O'Shaughnessy. Stolen away. Here come the Cypress trying to make a move right in front. As Garrett Ross. There's a long shot wired wide of the net off the stick of Foley. So Alex Morrison joining with me, and here's the aforementioned number 84. undresses the defender, tries to feed it back out front. We still don't have a name on that unmasked man.
Hey, Jeremy. Yeah, we're trying to research that right now. The team did turn their roster in. It looks like it was a late roster addition, though. You can actually see he's a little out of uniform with that bright blue helmet. But he sure does have some moves.
So we'll see if we can get someone on that one, if we can make some calls. Here's another chance up the other direction, and a goal. That was a beautiful move there by O'Shaughnessy as he walks right in and beats the goaltender for the Cypress. And unable to make the save there was Jacob Robinson, and the OC Bears go on the board first.
Yeah, it was an incredible move. He dipped his shoulder a little bit and then just roofed it right over the glove. And they're up 1-0 here in this really do-or-die game for this team.
So I know, Alex, you have an update on their results so far here in the tournament.
Yeah, the Bears played a tough match earlier today. They lost 4-1. Good news is they kept the goals against down. But, I mean, really, going into day two, being 0-2 is not the way anyone wants to be, especially when we have four teams that get knocked out, do not make the playoffs the next day. And, yeah, it was the Palma Knights that ended up taking it to them. Verbero, on the other hand, they won their first game. They were able to beat the excitement. They won 5-2. They look pretty darn solid, and they were trying to carry some momentum here into this game tonight. And after that quick penalty and the play being in their end most of the time, we'll see what happens.
So Chuck Baldwin getting a great deal of camera time here. And we've got a penalty over on the far side boards.
Yeah, a little late there on the whistle. Wrapped him up, almost a headlock, head first into the boards. Looks a little bit shaken up there, but a pretty obvious call. Just wondered what happened there with the whistle.
So Willie Boyle was the man that was taken down. He is back up onto his feet. Good thing to see that. So, Alex, if you will, can you lay out the division just a bit? How many teams are in it? How many teams make the playoffs? So on and so forth.
Yeah, absolutely. 12 teams total in Narch Pro. This 2017 East Coast Finals, and of those 12, eight of them move on to the quarterfinal. Obviously,
so no bye this year for the first place team.
That was something that was discussed when creating the schedule, but really this division is so deep this year, and all these teams have so much talent that if someone does get a tough draw, at least they have a better chance of making the playoffs, taking eight rather than seven.
I know that that's been a key element in past years, getting that bye to move on to those games. So it looks like we've got an update on that player, number 84. Actually, Okay, well, we still do not. Alex, you may have to have you get on your horse at halftime and take a jog down to the OC Bears bench. Or perhaps, there is the problem. It looks like our stat runner, Brett Martin, was unable to get the... Oh, no, that is a correction.
That's correct. The Cypress. See, the Cypress, we'll get this figured out. A little statistical error here, and we'll get things
fixed up here. Meanwhile, the Cypress back the other direction, and the player there hits the deck hard, and here comes... The Bears back the other way. They have a lead in this hockey game, and forced to be sharp there was Robinson. So the play comes all the way back down into the end now. And I see Brett Martin over there in the score box. I'm sure he's working hard on trying to figure out the situation with number 84. Here come the Cypress back the other direction. They trail this hockey game 1-0. Alex, I have yet to see the excitement play. You mentioned that they are 0-1. Have they played their second game, or do they get that tomorrow?
They don't. They and the Roadrunners both only had one game. They had some rostering issues, and we ended up actually having that game scheduled for 11 a.m. tomorrow. So each of those two teams will play three games tomorrow.
Wow.
Pretty grueling task there in the pro division. And I'm sure by the time we get to that third game late in the evening, there'll be some pretty exhausted players out there.
There's a turnover now for the Cypress, coming back the other way. Got a 2-on-1 developing, possibly a 3-on-1. They elect not to pass, and a questionable decision there by number 20, Krunagel of the Cypress, as he had two players with him. Good defensive effort there. by the OC Bears. Number 66, Bobby Sands with a puck out of play. 8:01 left to go here in the first. Still 1-0 our score for the OC Bears.
Yeah, we're sitting here at the angle that Kruenagel was actually looking toward the slot. And you did see the Bears come back in a pretty decent fashion, making sure to clog up any passing lane. And Kruenagel, rather than trying to force the pass, just forced a shot, and unfortunately went off one of the Bears players.
Wow, another big collision in front of the net, as going hard to the net was Adrian Sosa. He says the puck is in. There's a Vibero Cypress player that is down and looks to be in a tad bit of pain. The goaltender was taken down too.
Yeah, I think he's right. We're pretty far away here, but it did look like the puck had snuck in there due to that collision. The defenseman for the Cypress ended up taking out that OC Bears player who was crashing hard.
I think that's Hodge.
But it does look like maybe the puck rolled in just a smidge after the whistle, perhaps. Or perhaps they said there's no goal just due to the fact that someone was down hurt.
Well, Purcell is out there telling the official. I think if you're a Cypress player, you want to... similar call to what happened against them in the first period where their, or earlier in the hockey game, where their player crashed the net hard and took out the goaltender. Well, similar situation.
You know what? It was somewhat similar, yet somewhat different there, Jeremy. You had the player for the Cypress come in on his own, take the shot, and then on his own accord, he ended up going into the goaltender, where in this case, the Bears player came in, tried to take the shot, wanted to steer wide of the goalie, and that defenseman pinched him off there and actually knocked him back into the goaltender.
The barrel's still looking for the equalizer here. Purcell couldn't get a stick on it. Trying to twist away with it, and finally coming up with it is Bobby Sand. Number 66 gets the return pass on the near side boards. Tried to chip it back. Almost a turnover. Dangerous play, and here come the Bears back in the other direction. Up ahead of the play now with it is Baldwin. Shot goes wide into the corner. Good body there as two Cypress players try to chip away at it and get control of the puck. Only one Bears player, and he's doing a good job of keeping it away, and he comes free with the puck. What an individual effort there. I'd like to give him kudos, but I can't see his number at the moment. Finally, I do. It's number 93, Daniel Sosa. He's got the puck now with it. Up ahead to Baldwin. Nice sauce out in front. Shot. Oh, and that one just missed. The rebound on the backside, and that one went off the side of the net.
What a beautiful saucer pass by Chucky Slick there from the corner right into the slot.
Here comes Purcell working wide, and that one goes off the goaltender into the corner. Now, that's one other thing, Alex. I'm not sure who's manning the pipes. For the OC Bears, the only goaltender listed on their roster is Blake Ducker, but he's listed as number 30, whereas the goaltender is wearing number 67. So not sure if that's Ducker or not. I don't see another goaltender on the bench for the Bears. Long pass up ahead, right onto the tape, shot, and it goes high and over the net, as Connor Cafferty had gotten free behind the play. Here comes the Cypress back the other direction. Unable to work his way through there was Ross. And the aforementioned number 84 has the puck for the Cypress. 5:05 left to go here in the first half. Ross has shot right in on the goaltender, and Ducker A. All make the save. 4:57 left to go here in the first half. Bears still on top, Alex, 1-0.
Yeah, this game has moved along somewhat slowly. I don't know if it's teams feeling each other out. We have had a few collisions, a few players, but it you almost get the feeling that they're saving a little bit of gas in the tank here for the second half.
Last game of the evening here at the 2017 NARCH Finals, day one. We will be here for 11 days? 10? 11? What did you tell Customs?
I told him I'd be here for 5 days, Jeremy.
There's a bang along the boards. Ross, nice feet out in front. And there he is, number 84. Oh, and another big play as they tumble down in front of the net. A couple players, Ross and company, having words. One of the big boys for the OC Bears come walking in to kind of police things. That's number 92, Miles Harvey. Alex, I believe you have some information on Miles Harvey.
Miles played about 100 games in the ECHL, even a couple of games in the American League. A lot of professional ice hockey experience there.
There's Harvey with the block shot, and here comes the lanky lefty right up the floor. Tried to get the return pass, gets it, feeds it right out in front, and unable to get a stick on it there was Sosa. Bears corral the loose puck, though, after a good scoring chance. Across the zone was Russolello. Errant pass there. Here comes Ross back the other direction. He's got speed. He's got a step. Ross shooting, and a nice save there by the goaltender for the Bears.
Yeah, Ross tried to go five-hole there, and the Bears goalie got his stick down to block that area.
That's what you got to do, Alex, is block that area.
It's my new tagline. We have a delayed penalty coming up here on the Cypress. Looks like another stickwork penalty. Kind of been the theme of the day here in the Pro Division.
Yes, it has. Goaltender for the Bears had a little pep in his step as he was heading over to the bench. Alex, I am guessing that's got to be Ducker just in another jersey. I think I got a good look at him. I think that is Ducker. So the Bears on the power play here. They swing it down low. Baldwin back up top, and now they get it back over to Baldwin now inside the circle. His pass couldn't find the mark. Bears working the diamond here. Baldwin had a shot deflect. Cypress player lost the stick, but able to get it back. Here they come back the other direction now on the shorthanded unit. Stepping in, there's a shot that is dangerous off the stick of Aaron Schwartz that goes wide of the net. Baldwin again with it. Tried to feed it back, his pass is intercepted. Cypress come back across the red line with it. And another number that's missing there, number 19. Some updates on these rosters. It is still the first game. Looks like Nick Smolinski, who wasn't on the original roster, so. And now we're going to have another penalty as Purcell just putting in some work from his knees there. Puck goes all the way back down into the Verbero end, so they get the goalie off the bench. Once they cross that red line, they will not be allowed to bring it back into their own zone. So they're kind of picking and choosing. Finally, they do bring it into the offensive end. And there's the touch up there by the Bears. So Cypress will go on the power play looking for the equalizer here. 1:28 left to go here in period number one, and the man advantage coming up for the Cypress.
Yeah, one thing I'll say about the officiating today, it sure has been consistent. This is a hooking penalty to follow that high sticking penalty that went the Cypress's way. And really, it's been kind of a consistent theme here. Body contact, it's okay. Want you to play hard, you can play physical. Just keep the sticks out of it.
Quick reminder, folks, make sure you make a video of your NARCH Finals experience and tag it on Instagram at NARCH Finals Hero for your chance to win a new GoPro camera. That contest will run throughout the length of the 2017 NARCH Finals. Another save there by Ducker. So GoPro, a new sponsor here at the NARCH Finals, yeah, Alex.
I'm very excited to have GoPro on board. And as far as that video is concerned, and that doesn't have to be, oh, we're going to show you, I'm going to get my hockey highlights and put a clip together. No, it's show your team at the pool. Show them out at the CN Tower, the Hockey Hall of Fame. show the overall Narch experience and what it's like and see if he can win.
Yeah, so many things to do here in the greater Toronto area. I remember you and I and your wife many moons ago going, and there is a big shot there by Garrett Ross, who finally steps into one and buries it past the goaltender Ducker to make it 1-1, but down to Niagara Falls and made of the mist and all that good stuff.
Still have a great picture from that one, Jeremy. That was a good time quite a few years ago.
Yes,
that,
it was.
That shot was great, though. There was a screen in front. Goaltender didn't see it come until the last second. High blocker side, and he just didn't have enough time to react and get that blocker up there.
So the Cypress tie things up on the power play here, closing in on 1 minute left in period number one. Ross is very tough on the offensive end, and it's rare that you can keep him completely off the scoreboard. He was buzzing throughout this game and finally was able to light the lamp. There's a, oh, what a shot. I don't know what that hit. That hit the
middle
dasher.
Stanchion behind the net.
And wow, we've got another penalty coming up. This one's going to go against the Bears, I think. Not sure what happened there. That was an offensive zone penalty.
Looked like a pretty good check behind the net where he took a guy out. Not sure who was that hit the deck there, but it was a pretty violent collision.
So, again, good job by the officiating, not shutting things down here in the last game of the night. Still keeping that same standard as Swims had it go off of his stick momentarily, and Swims just sends it towards the net. And elects to just get the whistle there with 11 seconds remaining here in the first half. Ryan Foley, the guilty party here for the OC Bears. We have the penalty time up there, 1:30. And here's a chance right out in front, trying to bang it home for the Cypress was Corey Hodge. And good to see Hodge back out there, as I think he was shaken up earlier in the hockey game, but he's back out onto the floor now. And so that'll do it for our first 15 minutes of play. And our score is 1-1, the Verbero Cypress and OC Bears. Faceoff controlled by the Cypress to start off. So Verbero with the puck now. Under a minute to go here in their power play. Just underway here in the second half. Stepping into a shot, looking. Ross, shot goes off a leg of a Bears player. Blocked out in front by Novalis, comes back up top. Cypress setting it up once again. Here's Ross, Ross feeding across. Purcell, shot, save. Comes free once again. I just tugged off the puck. Now it's finally broken free back the other direction. And they'll just sauce it down into the corner, and the Bears will go on the change. Here comes Ross breaking free across the red line. Ross has got Purcell providing the screen. It may have hit Purcell in front of the net. Stays out of the net. 13:35 left to go here, and both teams are back to full strength. Stepping right in, having it and losing it, but tracking it back down is the Golden Jet, number 84. They fight for it across in the neutral zone. Baldwin had it and lost it. Finally squirts free now to the Cypress, trying to go wide on the play. Looking for it there is Aaron Schwartz. He had it knocked off his stick. Tries to feed it back up top. Baldwin with the steal. Comes into the slot. Baldwin's shot goes up high off the glass and into the netting out of play. And we'll have a whistle. 12:56 left to go here in the second period. Our score is 1-1 here. Cypress and the OC Bears locked up in a good one. Our final game of day number one here at the 2017 NARCH Finals. That one squirts free right onto the goaltender. So the faceoff will still remain inside the zone there for Cypress. They steer it back into the corner, and that's where Verbera will set things up. Verbera looking for the lead for the first time here in the hockey game. So I've just received some information that number 84 is Matt Berry. Number 84 is Matt Berry for the Cypress. So that mystery has been solved. Here's a chance there, and oh, that one rings off the post as Baldwin fought his way through the slot and had the goaltender beat and rung one right off the crossbar. Still 1-1 our score. 12 minutes left to go here in the second half. Both teams with good scoring chances. Come back the other direction with it. Schwartz trying to track down a loose puck. It's taken there by the Bears, but they turn it right back over. Oh, they tried to hit Schwartz cruising through, but he was going for a line change. So Matthew Berry, our player there, Alex. Play settled and gathered down just a little bit for the OC Bears inside their own end across the red line now. Swooping up, trying to find Baldwin. Baldwin is really buzzing on this shift. This time that shot goes wide of the net. Rebound tracked down by the Bears. They've done a good job of possessing the puck here in the start of the second half. There's a nice move out front. That one tried to go wide on the goaltender down low, and it just missed the side of the net. Tracking it down again for the Bears, Connor Cafferty. And it's forced back in to the OC Bears, and both teams making personnel changes here. Fresh legs out onto the floor now for the Cypress. Twisting and turning is Connor Cafferty. Cafferty saucers one back into his own end, and again the Cypress shuttling players in and out through the player's bench. Here's a nice move through the center of the floor. Trying to go between the legs, it's knocked free. Good defense there by the Cypress. It's finally swept off the stick by Cromie Jr. Here comes the Cypress back the other direction. They lose it, and it squirts into the corner. The Bears should come up on this one first, but it picks up some speed and goes right in front of the players' benches, and that's where the Cypress have it. Bodies come together there, and it's finally tracked down by Cafferty, and he regains possession. 10:12 left to go here in a tied hockey game. There's a turnover out in front. Trying to get it free was Kruenagel. Couldn't find the handle. Fed it out in front. And it missed Cromie Jr.
Yeah, Kruenagel's pass just wasn't quite on target. Handcuffed Cromie, and puck went the other way.
OC Bears track down the loose puck. 9:45 left to go here in the second. Tracking back the other way. There's a hard shot that rifles off the stick of Adrian Sosa. Bears back up on it now. They send it back into their own end. Bears have been the quicker team thus far, Alex, getting to those loose pucks and creating scoring opportunities.
They have been. They've been a little bit sloppy, though. Not able to hold on to the puck for a long time, not being able to get Verbero chasing, and that's why our game's 1-1.
Here come the Cypress back the other way. They have not led in this hockey game. They trailed 1-0, tied it up. And that's where we stand, 1-1. Here's Garrett Ross looking for a second goal of the game. It's knocked off his stick. Purcell, shot, scores! Purcell picked up the loose change in front of the net, and he sent it past the goaltender, and the Verbero Cypress, just like that, have their first lead of the hockey game.
That was an innocent enough-looking shot, just about top of the circle. Just threw it at the net, and the goalie was already down on his knees and all of a sudden looks behind him, and there it is in the net.
So Eric Purcell in his second year of duty here for the Verbero Cypress puts his team on top for the first time, 2-1. 8:45 left to go here in the second half. And the OC Bears will be forced to come back now in this hockey game. Here comes Baldwin. Baldwin tried to sneak his way through, lost the puck and almost lost his footing. Ross leaves it behind the net for Purcell.
Yeah, every time Baldwin's been on the floor, there's been a little bit of a spark for the Bears. He's used his speed, used his aggressiveness to try and generate some opportunities.
There's a feed across for Ross, had it knocked off his stick. Bears can't break it out of their own end, though, as Hodge intercepts. Up ahead to Barry. Barry back to Purcell, makes a nice move on the outside. The left-hander goes wide again, and Purcell goes down. And that's an easy call for any official. And the tripping call will put the Cypress back on the power play.
Yeah, a little bit lazy, just reached out there with a stick, got right into the skates. And boy, oh boy, with only 8 minutes to go, to be shorthanded but down by one is not the place you want to be if you're the OC Bears.
Cypress have been fairly efficient on the power play thus far in the tournament. They set it back up top now. Corey Hodge running the show from the top of the box here. This is Barry with it. Him and Hodge play catch. Garrett Ross touches the puck for the first time. They've got Purcell in front of the net. It's usually where he operates his office on the power play on deflections and rebounds. He's already taken a couple from some friendly fire down there in previous power plays. Here comes Garrett Ross stepping in, shooting one that goes just wide of the net. Barry on it quickly. Glove down there by Hodge. Extending the pressure a little bit for the Bears was Garrett Vazlett. Nice feed in front. Shot scores. Barry buries that one as a great pass in front by Purcell. And the Cypress look sharp once again here on the man advantage.
Yeah, a little over-aggressive there on the penalty kill. The man at the top of the triangle goes a little bit out of position. That forces the left D up and out of that triangle, and the puck just goes tic-tac-toe because now you have three white jerseys wide open, and with crisp passing and a great shot, it's an easy goal.
So the Cypress extending their lead here in the second half to now 3-1, so penalties proving costly for the Bears. We'll have to stay out of the box to keep in this hockey game. There's one sent right towards the net. Schwartz tried to get a stick on it. Puck is fired all the way back down into the Verbera end. Out to play it was the goaltender, Colley. He settled it down there for his defenseman, and here come the Cypress back the other direction. So Verbero looking to go 2-0 here in the Narch Pro Division, and that will set them up pretty for a possible playoff berth. Who was it that they played in the earlier game, Alex?
They played the Excitement with J.C. Campagna and Larry Adegoke.
And the score in that game?
5-2.
5-2. George Brown behind the bench?
I didn't see the game.
Okay. Always curious to see what type of talent George puts together. There's a pocket pick right out in front, and a nice save there as the Bears player Cafferty had a good chance, but from an off angle.
And the Bears' schedule tomorrow doesn't get any easier, that's for sure, as they play the Labeda Snipers first thing and follow that up with their fourth game against the Halton Coyotes.
Well, if you recall last year when the Snipers made that prolific run to the championship, and there is an easy penalty call on the Cypress That's going to be Smolinski headed to the box. The Bears probably gave the Snipers the best game of the tournament last year.
All right. I didn't know that.
They did. You want to go back into the Narch annals and look that one up? It was a very close and tightly contested game. I believe it was a first playoff game for the Snipers.
All right. Well, and now as far as Verbero, looking at their schedule tomorrow, they play the Montreal team, MB Montreal. And then later on in the day, they play Black Ice. So two tough games for them tomorrow as well.
I think the Montreal game is very winnable.
It is, but with Montreal, they had their first day today. They get to go back to their hotel, sit there, figure out, all right, here's what we did right, here's what we did wrong. And I see them coming out a different team tomorrow.
So looking to cut into the lead now. Trying to send one in was Russolello. They track it down. They're back the other direction now with it. Trying to feed it out front. Working it down low. Trying to center it out front now, and it's steered aside. They've got Harvey, the big body, right out in front of the net. Comes back up top. Here's Russolello. Russolello didn't even look at a shot there. Steering it down low. That one goes up off the crossbar, perhaps. Garrett Ross couldn't track it down. Still 25 seconds remaining here in the man advantage. Here's a good chance. Out front, shot scores! What a beautiful pass, and Russolello able to get a stick on it and bury it, and Cafferty makes that play happen. The power play goal makes it 3-2.
Yeah, Cafferty did make the play happen, but we had this heck of a battle in front with Miles Harvey. And he was taking advantage of the fact that he knows the referees don't want to make an even-up call. It's 3-1. And he used his professional experience and took some liberties there and ended up taking a Verbero Cypress guy down in front, opening that hole up.
Mr. Harvey, a men amongst boys out here on the roller hockey floor. 4:25 left to go. He saved the best for last here at day one of the 2017 NARCH Finals.
All Jeremy's one-liners come out now, but what are you going to do day two, Jeremy?
Well, let's cross that road when it comes. Here's a chance right on front and all alone, and the goaltender Colley has to be sharp there to preserve the one-goal lead, 3-2. Verbero on top, and we're going to have our first timeout of the evening called, this time by Verbero, as they do not like the situation as they're running around just a bit here. They led this hockey game by a score of 3-1. The power play goal makes it 3-2, and just like that, the Bears were hunting for the equalizer. Another exciting event coming up tomorrow, Alex. We've got the NARCH Pro Skills Competition, and we've got some big bucks on the line for our top sniper, and skater, and goaltender.
Yeah, $500 for each one of the winners. Should be a great event, and we look forward to a good crowd here, cheering these guys on, and a lot of eager participants.
Well, I'm not the biggest math guy, Alex, but with the exchange rate, that $500 can quickly turn into 600 Canadian.
Oh, no, that's 500 Canadian, Jeremy.
Oh, okay.
Oh, we have a breakaway here for the Cypress.
Barry walks right in and scores. This kid has come out of nowhere, not on a roster, not in your program. But he has really put his mark on this hockey game. That's his second goal, Alex. We'll get him a black helmet perhaps tomorrow. But I tell you what, his blue helmet is a shining star out here on the floor.
Yeah, sure. He's number 84 in his jersey, number one in your hearts. And holy cow, what a great shot. And what wheels. Where is this kid from? Come on.
We're going to have to really look him up and get some of that research staff on this one. Because that's not a name that's familiar either. And there's a lot of recycling of players amongst these pro teams where you get some guys that maybe, you know, perform for another factory unit. But Barry showing up on the scene and really making his mark on the hockey game. There was a pass out in front as it's, oh, that's a huge whack right there. And I'm gonna have to see here. That is a borderline major penalty. We'll see what happens. We've got a Cypress player that really took a hard whack. And here's Barry right out in front trying to get the hat trick goal. Barry just possessing the puck. The extra attacker is out onto the floor now for the Cypress. Barry working through the middle. It's handed off back to Ross. Ross goes between the legs. Puck squirts free into the corner now. They battle away for it. Ross kicks it up the boards to keep it away. Nice pass there. Comes right back up top to Hodge. Hodge over to Ross. Still a delayed penalty. We're under 3 minutes. Hodge with it down in the corner to Barry. Barry looks off a defender, backs up. His pass is intercepted and touched. Let's see if this is just a minor. That was a borderline misdemeanor.
Yeah, that's a ugly incident that happened out there. Some frustration, but it's a 4-2 game on day one. So they really need to keep their heads here, know that they're playing tomorrow, not do anything to get them tossed out, and not injure the other team as well. And Jeremy, I do have a little information on Matt Barry here, assuming it is the same Matt Barry I just looked up. Matt Barry that played over 100 games in the ECHL, 20 games in the American Hockey League, and 4 years at Michigan State University, and it looks like he may have started all 4 years.
Well, that's a nice pickup for the Vibero Cypress. Now, I know Eric Purcell is a current attendee at Michigan State University. Maybe that's where the connection lies to get him in on the squad. Nice shorthanded attempt there by Baldwin. He has really been a spark plug out there for this Bears team. 1:08 left to go here in the man advantage. And here comes Baldwin back the other way with it. Baldwin working one-on-one. Baldwin trying to make a move and runs out of gas there and loses it. And back come the Cypress the other direction.
Yeah, it's Corey Hodge with a good stick there as not buying the little shoulder deke and just getting it down there and getting in the way of the puck.
Hodge, the captain of this Vibero Cypress team. Pretty wide geographical mix for this Cypress team. They have quite a few players hailing from the Michigan area, but they pulled from other regions of the country as well.
We could say that a little bit of the same for the OC Bears, pulling a player from San Diego.
One. 20 seconds remaining in the man advantage. The Bears trying to kill this one off to stay in this hockey game here. The puck is bouncing in front of the net, still loose. And finally, it's gloved there, I think, just momentarily by the goaltender, Ducker of the Bears. He'll hold on for a whistle. 1:21 left to go here in the second period. Only 11 seconds remain in the man advantage.
So if I'm the Cypress here, I'm really keeping a defenseman back, which exactly looks like what they're doing here, to watch the guy coming out of the box, because that's the OC Bears' chance here. It's a 1:20 to go. 11 seconds go by. That guy comes flying out of the box, and they look for a long bomb pass and a breakaway. So, yep, the Cypress are staying back there, and penalty's just about up.
All right, so the goaltender for the Bears is off the floor. They've got the extra attacker out there now. So, and I like this move. You're down here by 2 goals, 1 minute left. You're already 0-1 in the tournament. Possibly it'll come down to a situation where goals against isn't going to matter, so go ahead and take that chance. Cypress still trying to get control of the puck. Schwartz fires it down. It ends up on the legs of Garrett Ross. Ross working one-on-one on an empty net. Ross snipes that one home, and it's now 5-2, and I think it's all but over but a formality here with 40 seconds left in the hockey game. And you're seeing some extended facial time there from Baldwin over there on the bench, and he is just not happy with the performance of his Bears team here in the waning moments.
Well, Jeremy, you talked about it being a good move, you thought, taking the chance, but having lost that first game 4-1, only 4 goals against, they were kind of up. As far as the 0-2 teams here, they had the fewest goals against up until this point. Now that chance that they took here, pulling the goaltender, could end up costing them tomorrow.
Yeah, true, but I look at it this way. You're going to have four teams that aren't going to make the playoffs, so there's not going to be too many more teams that are going to be 0-2 at this point.
Yeah, fair enough to say, but really, you really have a chance to make it to the playoffs with one win here.
Well, even so, with that being said, as the final seconds tick away, a combined total of 6 goals really is still putting them in the driver's seat of 0-2 teams.
Yeah,
compared to some of the other teams that we've seen earlier today.
Absolutely. The combined total at 9 goals. Really,
I thought they
4-1 they lost. Okay. Yep. And then this one at 5-2. But really, a competitive hockey game. Verbero just took advantage of the chances they had, and the Bears a little bit of bad luck, hitting a couple of posts, a crossbar, some great saves, and there we have it.
Tell you what, this OC Bears team sports a pretty large roster too. 12 skaters, which in a roller hockey game is a little bit unconventional when you get some of those players that just aren't able to get out there on a regular shift with 12 players. But nonetheless, they were able to keep this one tight and had the lead for quite a period of time, up 2-1. And then just a onslaught there by the Cypress in the second half. 4 unanswered goals, and that's going to do your final score, 5-2. Alex, any final thoughts?
Good first day, just like you said, and we really look forward to day two. The intensity, as good as it was today, is going to turn up a little bit more tomorrow as teams know exactly what they have to do to make the playoffs.
So remember, all these pro games here on Arena Rink. Besides that, all of the games here on the Arena Rink live streamed on the Narch live stream. We've got skills competitions coming up tomorrow as well. Lots of action here on day two at the 2017 Narch Finals. For Alex Morrison, I'm Jeremy Ellis, and all of the production staff here in the control center at the 2017 Narch Finals. Thanks for watching day one. We'll see you bright and early for day number two.